Now here the question is, if the sides of triangle ABC inscribed in a hyperbola XY equals C square makes angles alpha, beta and gamma with an asymptote, then prove that the normal set ABC will meet in a point if cot 2 alpha plus cot 2 beta plus cot 2 gamma, it is equal to 0. So we have this rectangular hyperbola. And then a triangle ABC is inscribed in it. So we have this triangle ABC, which is inscribed in this hyperbola. Now let us assume that coordinate of this point A is CT1, C upon T1, B is CT2, C upon T2, and C is CT3, comma C upon T3. Now we have already worked out slope of any chord of this rectangular hyperbola, it will be minus 1 upon T1, T2. And it is given that these chords, they make angles alpha, beta and gamma with asymptotes. So say first one is 10 alpha. So from here we can write T1, T2 is minus cot alpha. In the same way we can write T2, T3 as minus cot beta and T3, T1 as minus cot gamma. Now we know that equation of a normal to a rectangular hyperbola can be expressed as this biquadratic equation CT to the power 4 minus XT cube plus TY minus C equals 0. And since it is a biquadratic equation in T, from any point, four normals can be drawn to this rectangular hyperbola. Say this equation will have four real roots, say T1, T2, T3 and T4. Now we'll write S4, which is product of all the roots, T1, T2, T3 and T4. And this value, it will be simply minus 1. So from here we can write T4 as minus 1 upon T1 into T2 into T3. Now in this equation, there is no second degree term. So we'll write S2. We know that S2 in this case is 0. Now S2 is nothing but sum of roots taken two at a time. So we can write T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1 plus T4 T1 plus T2 plus T3, and this sum will be 0. Now we already know that T4 is minus 1 upon T1 T2 T3. So we can write this as T1 T2 plus T2 T3 plus T3 T1 and then minus, here T1 will cancel, so it will be minus T2 T3 minus T1 T3 minus T1 T2 and it will be equal to 0. Now we can write this as cyclic summation, T1 T2 minus 1 upon T1 T2 and it must be 0. Now we know that T1 into T2 is minus cot alpha. So it'll be minus cot alpha plus 10 alpha. It must be 0. So we can write this as summation minus 1 plus 10 square alpha upon 10 alpha and it'll be 0. It will multiply by 2 and divide by 2 and it will take minus 1 common. So we can write minus 2 and this summation 1 minus 10 square alpha upon 2 10 alpha will be 0. This is nothing but this is 1 upon 10 2 alpha. So we can simply write summation of cot 2 alpha must be 0, which is simply cot 2 alpha plus cot 2 beta plus cot 2 gamma equals 0. So these normals at A, B and C, they'll be concurrent if cot 2 alpha plus cot 2 beta plus cot 2 gamma is 0. And this is how we prove such questions.